Welcome back to Hypnosis Today, where we explore how people are using hypnosis to achieve remarkable things. If you've just joined us, I have two more guests. Well, my first guest is Glenn Rotman. He's an honors grad of HMI College of Hypnotherapy, and he has with him his very special guest, Jim. Now, Jim came in to visit Glenn just to release and let go any negative inferences from a past relationship. Please help me welcome my guest. Jim, I want to start with you. Letting go of a past relationship, why didn't you just find somebody else? Why did you have to come in and see a hypnotherapist?
A half decade had gone by, and also it was, she had borderline personality disorder, so it was really stuck, and it was very confusing, and I thought there was something wrong with me, so.
You know, I'm going to recommend a book for you, Jim. It's called Stop Walking on Eggshells. You must get it. Okay. And you'll think that someone peered into your relationship and just took notes. And for those of you at home in the studio audience, borderline personality disorder is when someone is very charismatic, really wonderful, and yet when that person has a negative emotion, that person takes it out on the individual who loves him or her best. So any sadness or anger or fear is taken out on the person who the borderline feels closest to. So it becomes very, very confusing, very overwhelming, and it leaves a pathway, a history of broken relationships. And it does make you feel like you did something wrong.
Yes.
And so a half decade, that's 5 years. See, I do math. I thought there'd be no math in this class. So it was very hard even 5 years later to let go of it. What was going on internally with you?
I was just thinking about it way too much, but I mean that wasn't even the main problem. The main problem, it was holding me back in my efforts to get a new, healthier relationship. I was just kind of stuck.
I get it. So why hypnotherapy?
A mutual friend had introduced me to Glenn, and we just started talking about it, and he thought that hypnosis would be able to help with the problem.
Absolutely. And I love that you told everybody that you know that you are a hypnotherapist at HMI College, and then friends of friends of friends, here we are, and we have someone who needs us. And I'll just tell you, the universe is a great place. Everybody who calls you, the universe has sent that person to you, and you can help. So what did you know about hypnotherapy before you met Glenn?
Not much. I'd gone to a hypnotherapist to quit smoking, and it didn't work.
Well, hey, I have a joke for you. You want to hear it?
Sure.
What do they call the person who graduates dead last from medical school? Doctor. There's hypnotherapist, and then there's hypnotherapist.
Yeah.
So you knew that hypnotherapy, in your experience, your hypnotherapist didn't help you with smoking. So what inspired you to go and talk to Glenn?
Oh, well, because I was talking to him anyways, and I even said to him, I don't think hypnotherapy works because I went to a hypnotherapist to quit smoking, and, he was very convincing. So
what happened, you skeptic you, when you went in to see Glenn? What was it like?
It wasn't that hard. It took a long time to go through the relaxation part, and the whole time my head wanted to fight him, so he came up with a thing where every time my head started to insult him or the process, I was supposed to raise my index finger.
And what happened?
And, I raised my index finger 50 times.
And then what happened?
Oh, well.
Knocked him on the head.
Boom. Yeah.
he found a way to calm that inner and outer critic in my brain.
Of course. Because that's called in hypnotherapy speak, projection. And as you mock and criticize him, in a way it's a mirror that you're mocking and criticizing the belief that you can actually be well and move on. Mm-hmm. And good for you. And each time, just to let you know, here, I'll tell you a secret, don't tell anyone, just between us.
All right.
Each and every time that you feel critical or skeptical of the process, you raise your finger, that overloads all of the senses. And the more you get overloaded, the faster and the deeper you'll go into the hypnotic trance for positive change.
Oh, wow.
So you get 5 extra bonus points for that induction. So once you were finally able to get overloaded, release the inner critic, and go down into the hypnotic trance, what did it feel like?
At first, nothing. I didn't even think, you know, that critic was very powerful. I didn't even think that I was under.
But then what happened?
That's the thing, is like, I don't really remember a lot of what happened.
Good for you. And how was your rumination or obsession or repeating thoughts about the old relationship after you finished seeing Glenn?
Oh, now they're, I would say, like 99.9% gone.
Wow.
Glenn had mentioned a lot about venting dreams.
Yes.
And I had about 6 of them.
And were you able to let go?
Yeah. And what was great, too, is I think, you know, he also knows how to interpret dreams.
Yes.
Because of this awesome school. Uh-huh. And so we would, you know, every time I had a dream, I would be convinced that it was a sign that I wasn't getting better, and I would write the dream down for him, and he would analyze it, and it would always be a sign that I was getting better and letting go.
The way the subconscious mind is like filling up a glass with water. If you fill it up, the old stuff on the bottom stirs up and then comes out. Mm-hmm. That's what dreams are, and as long as you don't take them literally, as long as you know that you're letting go, you get better and better and better. I want to return to that statistic that now about 99.9% of the rumination or the mind returning, we call them mind movies, returning what if, mm-hmm. has began to dissipate and is gone. What do you think about hypnosis now?
I think it's amazing.
Whether you believe in it or not, it's like gravity, Jim. Yeah. Whether you believe in it or not, I wish I had a nickel for every smoker who came in who said, I'm not hypnotized. This was a waste of time because I just stopped smoking on my own after seeing you 3 times. And you know what I say? Wow, you are amazing. And I guess you didn't really need to come. I'm just so glad you are now a non-smoker, right?
Yes.
So it didn't really feel like anything. And yet this post-hypnotic suggestion about the dreams allow you to release what you were storing and took down the repeating thoughts. What are you thinking about now? How have you moved forward? The proof is in the pudding. Tell me what your life's like now. Tell me about what your relationships are like now.
Well, you know, I'm a lot freer. I'm not like dragging the dream behind me. And I am open now to a new relationship. So like I've just been, I just bring less baggage to the table, and not just like in romantic relationships, but in all my relationships.
Really? Mm-hmm. So Glenn, mm-hmm. this is really interesting with my skeptical friend over here.
Yes.
Tell me, what do you do for a client who is holding on to a past relationship, especially when that person was suffering from some sort of a personality disorder, which is crazy-making? You know, I want to say those who live with the affected also suffer, you know? Mm-hmm. So what do you do?
You know, you do a couple things, but the first step is determining who they were in that relationship. To make it as simple and as profound as possible, there's basically 2 types. There's the thinker in the relationship, and there's the feeler in the relationship. And the thinker has, you know, more analytical, they're focused on careers. They can look at a checklist of pros and cons, and if the cons outweigh the pros, they can put the relationship away easier than somebody can who feels. The feeler is about relationships, about love, about romance, and they hang on even though logically that pros and con list still may be higher on the con side. That doesn't matter.
What were you, Andrew? Are you a thinker or a feeler?
Definitely a feeler.
I think you are too.
Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 32.
Ladies? Okay. So now we understand if someone's a thinker or a feeler.
Correct.
We explain to the person how that person will handle rejection. Yeah. What do we do next?
Well, then we get them in hypnosis, and when somebody is resistance, some of it is explaining that resistance is a good thing. You don't build strong muscles without resistance. Nobody grows without resistance. It's a part of your growth, and it's natural to be resistant to the process. You're going to have thoughts coming and going, and you're going to think, you know, you're in a beautiful field. No, I'm not. I'm on your couch, you know.
Yes.
And that's why we came up with a little ideomotor response to keep his mind busy. Because when he was thinking about doubt in the process, he'd raise his finger. And then eventually, those thoughts passed. So we just got him into hypnosis. So the first part we do, it's kind of a 3-step process, is we take him to the relationship, to moments that are, that will stand out for him, moments that are emotionally charged, be them good or be them bad.
So emotionally charged, how about the time when he just knew he was in love? That's emotionally charged, in the mm-hmm. time that his heart was broken.
Yes.
So positive and negative.
Yes.
And then what do you do?
Well, we put him in the hypnotic state. And the one thing I want to speak about real quick is, we say that the mind can't tell fantasy from reality. I think a better way to explain it, because a lot of people go, yeah, I know what's reality, I know what's not, is when you're in hypnosis, in a deep state, and your critical mind is open, and we have you visualize or imagine yourself in a past memory, good, bad, indifferent, and you're in that moment, that fantasy is a reality therapeutically to your brain when you're in that hypnotic state.
Easier way to understand it, easier way for a skeptic or yeah. a scientist.
Yes.
Go ahead.
So when we bring that state back and they feel it, they think it, and they're in it, and then we have that same idiomotor response where they raise their finger when that feels real, then we make it bigger and brighter and more intense, and then we just pass and breathe through it and let it go. And we
yes.
bring it another moment up, same process, bigger, brighter, deeper, stronger, and you see it in their body, you see it in their movements, you see reactions. That's how I know he's in that state. Even if they're doubting it, we see their body and how they're moving, and they're there, and they bring it back and they pass it. And we do that a few times, and we allow those memories to clear. And then after we do that, before we finish up, we mention the venting dreams, that any residual emotions left to these scenes and any future feelings you're going to have in relation to this relationship, or they're going to clear through your venting dreams.
So I have to ask, I have to ask Jim to experience those great moments of love and pain that were trapped in there and rattling around, and bringing them up. Were you able to release them and let them go and let them pass?
Yes.
Pretty powerful.
It was. I mean, it wasn't easy.
No, it wouldn't be.
But
it's better than the alternative. When they get trapped in there, it's like a low throbbing pain. When you bring them up and release them, it hurts, but then it's over. And you know, you can't eliminate pain, but you can sure eliminate suffering. And it just sounds like this, let go of the suffering.
Yes.
So that's step one. Tell me step two.
Step two is, it's really important symbolically and internally to say goodbye to that relationship. And so we take him back into hypnosis, and actually into a room where he brings his old partner in, and essentially you tell them off. Everything you think about them, good, bad, indifferent, and you take that moment to say, you know what, I will never allow another relationship like you in my life. And you don't just say this to her, you say it to everybody that's ever made you feel that way. And you bring them all in this room. And this is a very intense moment in hypnosis when you're experiencing, somebody's experiencing this. So he's seeing her, not just her, everybody that made him feel less than, that put him in this moment. And this is the time to just close the door on every one of them.
So, Jim, you know, this type of stuff about getting all hooked up with a borderline personality, mm-hmm. I bet some of it was strangely familiar. I gotta ask, in the past, was there somebody, even in the family of origin, who was just really wonderful and really unpredictable?
Mm-hmm.
Why am I not surprised? And to bring that person, whoever that person was, and to say, I'm never ever going to allow someone who is crazy making, unpredictable, gives me the agony as well as the ecstasy mm-hmm. to say goodbye to that. What was that like?
In that moment?
Yes.
You know, it felt really good because we got to, in the hypnosis, vent a lot of these emotions that were kind of stuck.
Did it give you some insight into your family of origin?
Yes.
Bet you weren't looking for that with your hypnotherapist.
No, but I mean, yeah, it was, because you're right, I mean, it wasn't just the family of origin, it was like, you know, 25 of the same people that just had different faces, you know?
Well, you know, the subconscious mind goes for what's familiar, not necessarily for what is good.
I know, it's not fair.
Not fair. It's not fair. So, not just the family of origin, but 25 relationships. Really, really good. But there's a third thing.
Yes. Once we clear, now it's time to rebuild. So we take him into another hypnotic session and have him visualize who he wants to be, you know, how he feels about himself, confident, connected, only attracting people in his life that are the same. No longer accepting a relationship that will make you feel less than the way you used to feel in relationships. And we'll do the staircase technique, as we know, but maybe viewers don't know, where they visualize themselves on top of a 20-step staircase, and they see themselves calling the person they want themselves to be, you know, a visual calling of themselves. And every time they step, they go a deeper step into this person to where they get to the bottom. And then they celebrate that, you know, you are this new person now. And then we take them up to the staircase again with a visualization of just seeing themselves only staring at their feet as a grounding anchor. So when they walk the staircase a separate time, it's an association that can come back anytime they look at their feet. If they're feeling their old feelings they used to feel, going back into old ways of thinking, they can just simply look down at their feet, be in this moment, and all the associations we put in will come back.
Excellent. How has it improved your relationships romantically and otherwise?
You know, I just have a lot less baggage. You know, and I feel like I've gotten, I don't know if this is going to make sense, but I feel like I've gotten me back.
Yes. Your true essence.
Yes.
So hypnotherapy got you back.
Yeah, and then there's less fear too. Like I guess I used to get really, have a lot of anxiety in dealing with people, and now I just feel very in the moment.
It's nice, isn't it? So what would you say to someone who would like to release a past relationship about seeing a hypnotherapist?
Well, I would tell them to call Glenn.
Why Glenn?
Because he's the best.
He is the best. With that, I know that everyone is going to want to contact you, and you can reach Glenn Rotman at hmigrads.com. Now, this is seen all over the world. Mm-hmm. Do you also Skype or do telephone appointments or FaceTime?
Yes, it's a lot of fun to do Skype sessions.
Oh, it is fun. Yeah, so if you're in Southern California, it's also fun to see you face-to-face. Come and visit Glenn here in beautiful, sunny Southern California. If you're anyplace else, please feel free to Skype, FaceTime, or call. And that's Glenn Rotman on hmigrads.com. I want to thank Jim. I want to thank Glenn. I want to thank everybody in the studio audience and those of you watching at home. My name is Lisa Mackenberg, and I hope you'll tune in next time and learn more about the conscious and the subconscious mind on hypnosistv.com. See you next time.